Blackstone Audio presents Diamond Rings Are Deadly Things, A Wedding Planner Mystery by Rachelle J. Christensen. This book is read by Kirsten Potter. Chapter 1. Bridal Heirloom Creations, Ring Pillow. Using fabric that is the same or similar to the fabric of the bride's gown, make a small pillow. Add a personal touch by hand embroidering the names of the bride and groom on the fabric. To complement the wedding dress, decorate the top of the pillow with lace, sequins, beading, rhinestones, or a satin bow. To add a splash of color, select narrow ribbon that coordinates with or repeats the wedding colors. Stitch the ribbons to the top of the pillow and then tie the rings to the pillow before the ceremony. Courtesy of www.mashedpotatoesandcrafts.com. The air was charged with an expectant current as I unlocked the back door of my wedding planning headquarters. Pausing for half a second, I ran my fingers along the smooth vinyl lettering printed in teal on the metal door, Adrielle Pyper's Dream Weddings, where happily ever after is your destination. Those words were the realization of a lifelong dream for me, even though I never would have guessed I'd be setting up shop in Sun Valley, Idaho. I had loved my life in San Francisco, but after what happened, I needed to get out of the city and back home to my Idaho roots. The anxiety that had plagued me for over a year was finally fading. For once, I wasn't afraid to step into the darkened room and flip the switch. The fluorescent lights illuminated everything I'd worked so hard for, and I felt like today might be the beginning of something different. The soft scent of lavender filtered through the air. It smelled like hope. My assistant, Lorea Zubiondo, arrived at the shop minutes after I came through the back door. Her dark hair looked glossy under the lights, almost black. The short layers were teased in the back. I joked that she was trying to make up for her 5'2" height impairment. "Morning, Adri." Her voice sounded chipper, and there was a lightness to her step. I noticed a bit of eyeliner and dark green eyeshadow accenting her deep brown eyes and barely kept myself from gaping. Lorea was a no-frills girl, so why did she have makeup on? I glanced at the clock, 8:15. "You're early today." "Couldn't sleep." Lorea tugged the measuring tape hanging from her dress mannequin. A few minutes later, I caught her looking at the clock. The eyeshadow suddenly made sense. "Ah, I see why you couldn't sleep. It's Wednesday. Guess I'd better open the front door in case we get a special delivery." "I'm excited about seeing the dresses, that's all." Lorea's gaze flicked to the clock again. "Me too." I didn't push the issue, even when I saw the hint of a smile lift the corners of her mouth. My own anticipation buzzed happily in the back of my mind as I turned the locks on the front door. I was ready to embrace this new venture, and I ignored the nagging thoughts of what if that kept trying to creep in and overshadow my visions of success. I tidied up the front of the shop, winding the satin ribbons in shades of forest green and burgundy on a spool. A customized ring pillow with coordinating ribbon to match the accent colors might be just the thing for one of my June weddings. I tucked an errant strand of blonde hair behind my ear, my fingers brushing my favorite pair of sapphire earrings. With my sketch pencil, I outlined ideas for the ring pillow. 10 minutes later, wedding chimes rang, and I heard a familiar whistle. Lorea and I hurried to the front of the shop, pushing each other aside in hopes of getting there first. At the last second, I let her pass. She was going for the guy. I just wanted to see if the shipment had arrived. A man dressed in a brown uniform waited out front, holding a scanner. "Hi, Colton," we greeted the delivery man simultaneously. "Hi, ladies, your wait is over." Colton motioned to the long box behind him. "I have a couple more boxes like this in the truck." Lorea pumped her fist in the air. "They're finally here. I'll sign for them." Colton flourished his scanner and Lorea signed, her grin widening. He took back the scanner, studying it for a moment before pushing a couple of buttons. "Zubiondo, I've been meaning to ask you."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.